here who has suffered a loss this past year. Chelsea and I share that with you and extend our sincerest condolences. Van claimed that he first saw me on my college campus when he was doing the lighting for a rock and roll group that he was touring with. But the first time that I remember talking to Van and seeing him was when some mutual college friends took me to the first theater that Van founded, which was Theater 369 in Somerville, Mass. And when Van found out that I was trying to make my living as a professional photographer, he immediately enlisted me to take photos of this next production, which was Harold Pinter's The Caretaker. And it was the first time, but not the only time, I've ever witnessed Van drawing people in to help in a create a big happy family for something creative that he was working on, because he believed so much in that. And so so I said yes. Van loved theater, and he was fortunate that he was one of the four American fellows who was selected for the Salzburg Global Seminars, which was a gathering of writers, producers, and directors from 51 countries on the power of theater, artistry, entertainment, and social commentary. He was mortified, however, upon being one of the first of the participants to arrive at the seminar. He went into the dining room, got his lunch tray, and sat down at a table where there were only a few other people, and only one sitting at this table. And he sat down and he said, "Hi, I'm Van McLeod from New Hampshire." And his table mate responded and said, "Hello, I'm Arthur Miller." That warranted a transatlantic phone call that night because he was so horrified. Van loved theater and he felt at home in all kinds, academic, community, and professional. He loved productions that tell a story and where the cast exudes the excitement and the magic that makes the production come alive, making it believable. Sorting through his home office, I have come across a number of script outlines that he planned to develop in his retirement years. I hold on to this vision of him heading off excitedly to his latest theater, his latest production, to a rehearsal, wearing not a suit and tie, but a cardigan sweater and sneakers, just as I found him all those years ago. I want to thank you all for including Chelsea and me tonight in this wonderful remembrance and this wonderful evening of theater. We feel very at home here with you tonight in this theater at this event, and we thank you so much for including us.
Collaboration. collaboration between local arts groups as well as local businesses.
And we are grateful for Rob's continued support of the New Hampshire Performing Arts community and the New Hampshire Theater Awards.
In recognition of his long and distinguished career in the New Hampshire Performing Arts community, we are pleased to present Rob with this honor that he so richly deserves, in which he would never seek for himself, the Francis Grover Cleaveland Lifetime Achievement Award.
I'm here at the Peterborough Players, and I'm one of the people that volunteers to work up here. I'm working concessions tonight, I think. I'm not building a set or on stage or something. I'll at least be in the audience, supporting the theater. I'll be involved in theater in some way or other, probably for the rest of my life. And I want to thank Actors Circle Theater and all the people who were involved with that.
Now I want to thank the Peterborough Players. You know, they told me what professional theater is all about. And again, I'm not going to read this thing because, first of all, it's boring. But it really is a team effort. And I remember talking to a guy at the Players one time, and he says, "Remember, if the audience applauds, leave them." Thank you.